Let's take the next heading, that is problems on beam reactions. This part of beam reactions, it is included in the chapter of equilibrium. It means we would be solving these beam reactions considering the beam to be in equilibrium. By equilibrium, we mean that this beam would be, it would be in a stable condition, means there won't be any disturbances on the beam. Like for example, if I consider this pen to be a beam subjected to various forces, then the resultant of this force would try to disturb the beam. But if we apply an equilibrium force in the opposite direction, that will cancel the resultant and beam would be brought to its initial stable condition. So here in beam reactions, whatever problems we are solving, we are considering the beam to be in equilibrium. So let me start with the first question, that's question number one. Let's read the question. A simply supported beam of 6 meter span has two concentrated loads of 8 kN and 10 kN at 2 meter and 4 meter from left hand support. Full stop. Find the reactions at two supports. This is the question. Now, they have not given us any diagram in this. So first, I would be using the data which is provided to draw the diagram. Let us start with this question. It is given that here we have a simply supported beam. A simply supported beam of 6 meter span. Span means the length of the beam. So it is 6 meter length. If I can draw the diagram for y'all. Here I have a beam. This is called as a simply supported beam. I'll say that at point A and at point B, the beam is supported whose span, or you can say length, is 6 meter. It is supported at its extreme ends. So that is why it is called as a simply supported beam. Next, it has two concentrated loads. The meaning of concentrated loads is point load of 8 kN and 10 kN at 2 meter and 4 meter from left hand support, means from the left hand support at 2 meters and 4 meters. If I can draw the diagram, at 2 meters we are having 8 kN load, at 4 meters from left hand support we have 10 kN load. Now here we have to find the reactions at two supports. It means because of the action of these forces, we would be getting a reaction at A and reaction at B. Because the loads are carried by these two supports, so the beam is supported at its extreme ends, we would be calculating how much reaction is offered by each of the supports. So our question in this is to calculate RA and to calculate RB. I'll write the solution for this. Now, as we can see in this problem, there are no horizontal forces. We have only vertical forces. So I'll say that considering the beam to be in equilibrium, I will say summation of Fy is equal to 0. Since no horizontal forces are there, so Fx you don't have to write here. And in summation Fy is equal to 0, upward forces would be treated positive and downward forces would be taken negative. Now, as per the convention, I'll say that therefore RA is positive because it is upward reaction at A. RB is also positive because it is upward reaction at B. 8 kN is downward, so negative. 10 kN is also downward, so negative. That's equal to 0. Hence, I will say that RA plus RB minus 18 is equal to 0. Therefore, RA plus RB is equal to, I'll shift 18 onto the other side, and this is my equation number 1. Now I'll keep this as my equation 1. Next, after writing summation of Fy, I would be using the second condition of equilibrium. In that, I will say that the sum of moments of all forces about A is equal to 0. Now what is this? Since I have forces here and they are at a distance, so I will be calculating the moment produced by the forces at point A and see what I get. So in summation of moments, I will be taking all clockwise moment as positive and all anticlockwise moment as negative. Therefore, if I want to calculate moment at point A, I'll start with RB. If we can see, moment produced by RB is in anticlockwise direction. It will be in the anticlockwise direction. So it is minus RB into 6 meter, the distance of RB from point A. So it is minus RB into 6 meters. Next, 10 kilonewton is at 4 meters from A. So it will be producing a clockwise moment. So plus 10 into 4 8 kilonewton is acting at 2 meter from A. Again, this is producing a clockwise moment. So plus 8 into 2, that's equal to 0. Hence, this becomes 40 plus 16. I will shift minus RB into 6 onto the other side. So that becomes 6 RB. Therefore, 56 divided by 6 will give me RB, and my RB answer comes out to be 9.33 kilonewton. This is my first answer. After getting RB, I will say that put RB in equation number 1. Therefore, in equation 1, I have RA plus RB. RB is 9.33 and that is equal to 18. So hence, I get my answer of RA, that comes out to be 8.67 kilonewton. That is my second answer. So if we look into this question, there they were telling us to calculate the reactions offered by the support, that is RA and RB. We have found out RA has 8.67 kilonewton and RB has 9.33 kilonewton. It means these much are the reactions offered by the simply supported ends because of load 8 and 10 kilonewton, and for this the beam would be in equilibrium. This completes RB.